I built it, you liked it, and asked me to make a tutorial on how to make it, so here it is. Hey, this is RonnygoBOOM, and I'm here to teach you how to build a completely automatic sorting system. Reliable sorting systems were invented in the summer of 2013 with the release of hoppers and the 1.5 update, and since then, the science of item sorting hasn't really changed. I play on a faction server that resets the map periodically, so I've made massive item sorting systems 4 times in survival, and I've learned some tricks, best practices, and troubleshooting hints that will help you create the best item sorter for you. Sorting systems are fantastic on factions and SMP servers, because although it takes a great deal of resources to build in the short term, the time you save when you come back from a big raid is completely worth the time and resource investment. JL2579 created one of the first comprehensive item sorters, and my design is strongly based on his original YouTube video. But I have some changes to make to his design, and some small suggestions that will make item sorting more reliable, easier to build, and much less frustrating. I strongly suggest that when you finish this video, you watch his tutorial on his advanced automated item sorter with my changes in mind. Links are in the description, and I'll also have a link at the end of this video. Also, you should definitely subscribe to his channel. He comes out with some really incredible inventions. We're going to start out by going over this overly simplified item sorter. It just has basic, repeatable, tileable design, very, very small storage, and it doesn't sort too many items. Right here I have it sorting 6 items. So we'll open this up, put some of these items in. If you end up putting items that it's unable to sort, they'll end up in this hopper right here, so that's why we need to add a chest at the end. And this will collect any junk that is not sorted. I call this my junk chest. And then we just wait for these items to sort. This works because this hopper right here has just enough items in it to produce an output signal of 1. If we increase the number of items in this hopper by 1, that comparator will read that item output and produce a redstone signal that's too long. Once this redstone right here is triggered, this repeater will trigger, which will turn off this torch. This torch powers this block, and right now, this powered block is preventing this hopper right here from absorbing items. If that were to turn off for just a moment, it would allow the one item from this hopper to be sucked down into the one below it, and then this hopper will place that one item in this chest. And that's how the item sorter works, and that's how all sorting systems are designed to work. Now, this is not a perfect system. If we have too many items in here, what happens is we produce a redstone signal that's greater than 2. We have 1, 2, 3. And if this one gets powered, then we have the redstone signal next to it, this repeater over here, getting triggered, and that will cause items to get sucked out of this blue one. And if that happens for too long, if that happens for more than enough time to take 18 items out, we end up with a blank spot in this blue hopper. And that can be really dangerous because any item coming from this chest and going over, including these orange wool, for example, will start to get sucked down in here, and we'll end up with all these sorts of weird items that we'll find in this chest right here. Then any item that goes through will be able to be sorted into this chest. And that's not really a sorting system, that's more of just a dump chest. And then we have to go back and repair. So that's why we don't use this tiled design, because these redstone can interact with each other and we don't want that. Instead, we use this system right here. This is a tileable design that changes it up so that this redstone can't interact with the system right next to it. I'll break this apart just right here. So here's the tileable design. We have the hoppers as before. And we're gonna do an alternating system where we have this one right here, and I'll just leave it here so you can kind of take a screenshot or do what you like with it. You can pause the video here to start to get used to this system. It's important to note that these two hoppers are both facing into the blocks, and it doesn't matter which way this one's going, as long as you have like a stream below, and you could put a chest here or you can put more hoppers and string this to wherever you like. but those are the most important ones. This block here is necessary to block the redstone from these two from interacting. So if we look at this over this finished model that we'll get to in a couple minutes, we can see that this block is important here because it prevents these two from interacting. The next alternate design is like this. Notice again, hoppers are pointing toward the block or the comparator. And this piston, once it reaches that second redstone with the number of items inside it, will push this block down to this torch, activating this repeater and doing the exact same thing as before. So this design right here is tileable. You can put these things right next to each other. So over here, we have a working system. I like to add a couple things to mine. I add some lanterns, some lamps, so that you can see which one is getting sorted. It's just kind of a fun little thing, but it's completely unnecessary. And I also like to add a little timer over here. Instead of using this one, I'm going to show at the end of the video JL's timer, or you could just go watch his video. He has a better timer, and we'll post that here. I also have a large input chest. I like to have large input chests because I have an off switch, so I can put as many items as I want here, and then when I feel like running them, then I can just hit the switch and it'll start to run it. I also put this note block here on the timer to let me know when the machine is running, just in case I forget. This is important because on multiplayer servers, if you leave the chunk while this thing is running, you risk breaking the whole system. Well, you don't really break the whole system, but what you do is you have a chance, depending on when you leave, that this torch will remain off. One of these torches, if it's sorting something, when you leave the chunk, when you come back in, this torch will be glitched and it will remain off. That's really dangerous because it will allow all the items from this chest to be sucked down into this chest, and then you'll start to develop an overflow. Items will become backed up, and then when this gets to 64, then it won't sort the things that it's supposed to sort, and then they'll continue down the line. One way to do this is just to grab a stack or half a stack of something and then put them all right here. It doesn't matter if you go over because, remember, the redstone doesn't interact with each other. And this will drop down to 18, 19, 20, 21, 22 items total. I like to have the most in this stack just in case something happens where a few more are taken out, because they'll fill themselves back up. The problem with this is, if we have several stacks of lime wool that somehow get into this sorting system too quickly, this one will drain all the way down to zero, and then this one will start to drain. But that leaves an empty spot that won't be automatically refilled. We have to come back and maintain and fix it because it will be broken. Once we have that empty space, any kind of item can go down into this chest, and then you'll end up with a big mess that you'll have to clean up. So instead, what I like to do is, instead of doing this and running the risk of that happening, if you take a named item, I just have some bone meal because it's really cheap. You can get a lot of it and it's easy to name. You can name a stack of it for pretty cheap, and then you just put one of each in there. Never ever put this into your sorting system. Never ever put this exact named item. You can put more bone meal. You can put bone meal named anything else, but don't put bone meal in named filler because then you'll run into the problem. But here, if we get a full stack of items, we cannot get more than that full stack, so it will never overflow. Let's say you do accidentally leave the chunk, or the chunk becomes unloaded while the sorting system is running. You left it on, and you want to make sure that none of this stuff is messed up before you turn off the sorter again or turn it on to run it. Well, that's why I have this here. This is just a line of redstone, and that's all it is. It doesn't connect to anything. All it is a line of redstone with blocks next to this hopper and the redstone next to this hopper. And all you have to do is hit this button, which should connect to the entire stream, and it will update all these blocks. When this is updated, the whole system will get updated, and any torches that are left off will be turned on. It's just a quick updater that you run before you turn on your system. Then we can turn on our system, we can do whatever we want on our base, we can go run errands. As long as we keep this this rendered. We want to make sure that this chunk is being loaded. If we decide that we have to leave or we want to leave the chunk, just shut it off, go do your business, and then turn it back on when you come back. Just make sure you leave yourself a little bit time for all the items to go through. Mine is gigantic, the one that I have in my factions base, and it takes up to 3 minutes to let all those items go through. So you might have to turn it off preemptively and wait a little bit for that to happen. Another problem that you can run into on multiplayer servers with these item sorters is the chunk border problem. On some multiplayer servers, redstone that crosses chunk borders acts weirdly. It sometimes gets delayed, sometimes the redstone stays on when it should not be on. So I've just created this as a proof of concept to show you that you can fit a fully stackable item sorter in just one chunk. I only have two stacks here that sorts a total of 64 items, but you could easily continue the stacks downward and not have to worry about that in one single chunk. If you're going to stack these in one chunk, make sure that there's enough space in between the hoppers for you to have a bare minimum of space to allow these hoppers to get out without having them absorb items from the upper layer. So, if you're going to judge distance, you need at least, I would choose more, but you need at least one space in between the top block in this layer and the bottom block in this layer. All right, let's build it. First, we delineate our chunk borders. To do that, all we have to do is look here. If we press F3, it'll show us. So look where it says chunk, and it says -19, 15. That's the chunk that we're in. If we step outside of it, just one single step, it'll change the chunk. So now it's -19, 16. And if I go to the left, -18, 15. So that's the different chunk coordinate. So we just go around the outside until we step outside, and then we place a block down inside, and that'll help us to lay down our chunk borders. It's easiest to make this in survival if you have a lot of scaffolding around. If you have a wide open area, and then you just make a couple lines of, say, some wood blocks to work with. So first we're going to build our scaffolding, but I'm going to build this in creative just to save time. We're going to start out with a long line of blocks, and it can be as long as you want it to go. Each one of these blocks, the length of this is equal to the number of items that you'll have sorted. So the next thing we do is we add redstone comparators in this kind of checkerboard pattern, all facing away. Next, we add blocks where there are no comparators. And then come over to this side, and we're going to add this checkerboard pattern on the front. Next, we're going to bring this down one block, come over, and then up so that we have a little loop right here. And I like to finish one complete row so that we know what it's going to look like when we're all finished. So over here, we're going to have hopper facing the wall, hopper facing the wall, hopper facing down. And this is going to be the whole system. There we go. The alternate system is going to have a downward facing piston and this same repeater pattern, repeater inside. But here, we're going to have a torch, a redstone torch, and that redstone torch will activate that repeater. Again, we need a redstone torch on this side, and then redstone across the top. Then we have to make sure that the two redstone don't interact with the block there. And now I'm just going to activate that piston once to pull that block up. So when we make this, what we're actually going to do is, once we have this little scaffold, we're just going to go all the way across with this one, all the way across with this one, same here. But first we're going to make repeaters. On every other one, we're going to place a redstone torch at the bottom. Wherever there's a redstone torch, we're going to look up and place a downward facing piston. Then we come across with blocks. We're going to delete this one because we already did that. Now we hook up our redstone. We need two coming from each one. Coming from each comparator. And finally, we add this block to separate the redstone. Now we're quickly going to activate each of these pistons just once to pull that block up. And this should be your finished product from this side. From the other side, we need to make sure that we have redstone torches here. This is the block that the repeater is facing into. Next, we have hoppers that point toward the comparators. So I'm just going to hold shift, look at this comparator, and then right along the bottom, hopper on every block or comparator. Then the same thing one block below. Oops. Next, we can add another hopper down here. And we can alternate between regular chests and trap chests. And below this, you can add as much storage as you like or need. The final step is to create a stream that goes across the top to shuttle the items that might get absorbed into this. And remember, we need to put our fillers and whatever item needs to get sorted in the last slot. You can start with as low as one item and then just run as many as you want through. And if you add things that go through the system, this will stack itself up to 18. One way to make a stream is to just put hoppers across the top. This is the easiest way to do it, but it's not the best. It causes a lot of server lag, and if you play on the faction server that I play on, Choicecraft, I strongly suggest that you use a different method that I'll show you in just a minute. But this stream is certainly easy, even though it costs a lot of resources, but you already have a lot of hoppers. Another way that you can make a stream across the top is with rails and hopper mine carts. I have a simple system over here that instead of hoppers on this line, we just have hopper mine carts. And I can add a couple so that it goes more quickly. These hopper mine carts will pick things up from the deposit and they'll shuttle around in a circle, depositing the items there. When all the items are deposited, or any junk items that don't get sorted, for example, I don't sort water buckets. So I know that that water bucket is just going to keep going around and around and around in a circle. So what I do is I activate the junk chest. I just have redstone hooked up to this rail so it'll turn. And then it'll absorb things into the junk chest as well while it's sorting. Unfortunately, this is an unreliable system because those hopper mine carts hold on to a lot of items and they need to go around repeatedly in order to deposit everything. Also, it's pretty loud, and if you want those hopper mine carts back when you shut off the system, so I'm going to change this rail to make them turn into this cactus and destroy themselves. The problem with that is a lot of the items might be left over occasionally, and also they don't drop themselves, so we can't just hook up a dropper elevator into this one and then just turn it on by clicking this three times or turn it off. We have to actually produce or make those hopper minecarts every time. With an unreliable system that's not as fast, I choose not to use this type of sorter stream. This one is the one that JL did, and I must say I'm very impressed. It's a fantastic system. I suggest you go over and check his video out for how to do that, because this is far superior. It causes less server lag. In fact, we are running into a problem with server lag on Choicecraft because of sorting systems, and the admins were thinking about banning it. But I think if people switch to this method, we may not have to ban sorters, which would be fantastic on the server. So we'll switch to these. This is a more reliable and faster method so I'm definitely going to use this in my next sorter. One last improvement for 1.8 that I have on JL's design is chest consolidation. He has a giant chest room with one chest for every single item in the game. And if you look at it from zoomed out, it's really daunting how he makes his sorter, and every single one has its own chest. But what I like to do is I like to consolidate my items so that different colored glass are all sorted into the same chest, because when do you really need a different chest for each type of glass? Of course, we can have infinite storage in the back. We can have as much storage as we like for this glass, so we don't have to worry about it overflowing. But I just like to have to open as few chests as possible if I need to. There's no reason to have redstone torches, redstone repeaters, and comparators all with their own chests. So I consolidate them together along with ores, things like this. I can show you a video from my actual chest room on how we consolidate, but here's how we consolidate. We have the same sorting system as before. I'm just going to take out this wall to show you. We have the same sorting system as before, and it sorts the same number of items, but here we have a couple of the items consolidated into the same chests. So here we have three items being sorted, and all three of them get put into this one chest that goes all the way down to glass. The same thing here. If you're going to decide how many items to sort into each chest, you should do a spreadsheet beforehand, before you make this sorter like we do. And I suggest that you start from the bottom. So I know that I want six different items in this chest. So I'm going to start from the bottom. I tower up with hoppers, make it across, add as many chests as possible, because chests will cut down on your hopper costs, on the amount of iron you use. And here we just have one item going into this redstone. But if we wanted to expand it, all we do is... this is the output for all the different sorted items. We just go across. So now we have 4, 5, 6 different items being sorted into this redstone. That way you can consolidate your chests and not have to worry about opening up 100 chests just to get the things that you need to make a trap. So let's just recap on the tips that you need to do in addition to JL's design. First of all, you have to have an off switch, and only turn your system on when you plan to be in your chunk for a while. Have lots of input chests so you can just throw everything in here and you don't have to worry about sorting it all the time. Just maybe once a while when you're going to be spending some time in your base, just turn it on and let them all sort and run through. He has a better timer than me, so go use his timer. But another thing, this updater is very important. Every single time that I run my sorter, I update these blocks just in case, and I haven't had problems with my sorter in months. Another thing, make sure this second hopper, if you use fillers, you're going to run into less problems than you would if you didn't use fillers, if you did this. So make sure if you have fillers, use them. There's no reason not to. And all you have to do is name an item and use that named item, and it'll sort out items based on their name. Only these items will be stackable. And watch out for chunk borders. If I wanted to continue this beyond a chunk border, it would be really simple. I would just continue the sorting system, but I would skip a couple blocks. I'd bring the stream across, and here is the border between this block right here and this block. Here's the border. Here's the border between these two blocks. So we're just not going to build a sorter on this block right here. So we're going to skip one, and then we'll start building sorters again here. It's no big deal. It doesn't take up that much more space. It just makes sure that you have that you don't run into any redstone problems due to the lag of these hoppers across chunk borders. All right, let's do a tour of my sorter. In previous bases, we'd like to hide the redstone behind some walls or some opaque blocks, but in this one we decided to kind of show it off because it's so massive, and we even added lamps so that as items go through, it lights up in one certain area of the sorter. So let's check it out. Over here we have the input. This is at the top of our base so that we can use gravity to take things down with hoppers. We could also have a If we wanted to do it lower, we could easily just add a dropper elevator, but we decided to just put this up here. It makes things easy because we have lifts on this server. So this is all the stuff that needs to get run, so I could turn on the sorter right here and show you how it works. The first things that happen is items are taken out of those chests upstairs and they're sucked down here, and then they're run through this timer to slow the rate down just to make sure that things don't get bunced, just in case. And then they start to go down there. Let's go down to sorter maintenance to take a look. Alright, so now we're in the sorter maintenance room. This is where we have the sorter. So, let's go over to that first drop, sorter drop. Okay, so this is where items enter the system. They go in streams of hoppers all the way around in that big circle on the outside, and then they come right to here on this block, and then they come down this way, and then they go all the way around the circle the other direction, and then they drop down, and you'll see that. Here, this stream of hoppers goes down to the next level. We have this same pattern that I just showed you in the tutorial that goes all the way around, and then on these lapis blocks, that's the updater. That's just the redstone signal that causes block updates all the way around in the circle. Next time we build the sorter, we're not going to have this stream of hoppers that goes all the way around. Instead, we're going to have that water stream that JL2579 showed, because it'll cause much less server lag and it'll actually be a better system. I like it better, it'll cost less hoppers, we'll just have to make a couple under chests and that's no big deal. It'll be two for every corner, so that's 2, 4, 6, 8 total ender chests for this level, and then 8 more downstairs, so that's really no big deal. Not that expensive. So man, this thing is so big. Oh, as you can see, we label what's supposed to be in each hopper on a sign above it. This is just for our own ease of use for maintenance. And then down here, we have the next level. I'll show you that. We'll just jump down. And it's the same thing iterated. And we have sorters on both sides. We have it on the outside and we have it on the inside. That allows us for more sorting in a smaller space. And building it in a circle like this is conducive for factions because we can have our base claimed in a smaller area. We could make this smaller if we want. We've made smaller sorters before. If we didn't want to claim so much land outward, we could easily just compact it into smaller areas and then have more stacks. But for now, we are very happy with this sorter. This is the best sorter we've ever built. It's given us the least maintenance problems out of any sorter. And it has every item in the game. Now let's go down and I'll show you the chest room. Okay, welcome to our chest room and Merry Christmas. Over here, we have every single kind of item sorted into various chests, but we don't have one chest for each item. Instead, we have different kinds of items sorted into chests that group similar things. For example, lapis is grouped with lapis lazuli. All the ores are in the same chest. All of our valuable items are in the same chest. Different kinds of plant goods, all the different kinds of dyes and flowers are all together. Carrots, potatoes, then miscellaneous food, meat is all together, fish are all together, dirt has its own chest, but special kinds of dirt gets its own chest as well. Next we have horses and saddles, and then other things to be smelted. These are actually sorted over here into these, and then the chests on the side are our own creations. These are all sorted into the same chest. Enderstone gets its own chest. Nether brick, soul sand, glowstone get their own chest. I'm just going to go through and show you all the types of items. All these redstone types of items go together. String and cobwebs. All the heads. Some of these are sorted. Player heads are not sorted, but skeleton heads, creeper heads, and zombie heads are automatically sorted. Spawn eggs are automatically sorted. These are all our books over here. Not sorted. These are individual items, so they can't be sorted. Only stackable items, again, are sorted. We have obsidian in its own chest. Other stone. 1.8 stone. We haven't had 1.8 come out yet, so none of that yet. Stone. Stone brick and all the stairs and slabs and things like that. All the clay items and then all the colored clay get sorted into the same chest. Sand, glass, and then stained glass. All the different colors are sorted into the same chest. Sandstone. Then we have miscellaneous items that get sorted. Iron, both ingots and blocks, and then things that are commonly made from iron are all sorted into this chest. Then we have coal, wood, all the different types of wood, just the wood themselves, and then the planks that they produce, and then all the different kinds of things that you can make from wood come in here. Chests, trap chests, torches, sticks, ladders, all that good stuff. Next we have wood slabs and stairs, wool and carpets. We don't have a lot of wool. Books and things like that. Name tags. Leather. And that's it. That's everything. Everything that does not get sorted, things like tools, for example, come into this chest. Potions. And every once in a while, some items that failed to get sorted. So we'll just grab this and run it through the sorter again. Sometimes it happens. It's no big deal. It's very rare that it happens, but with our system, we don't run into problems where it breaks the sorter when this happens. So I'm just going to grab some of this stuff, this armor right here, and this will all go to the to be salvaged drop for MCMMO salvage. And those will all get salvaged. And then I can grab some of the extra potions, and we'll do this here. And then the potions go right here, and this goes down into our potion. For more on this base, I will give a base tour in just a couple days. And I hope you watch that video. It's going to be fantastic. I'll show off the entire base, not just the sorter. And I'll show off the sorter in less detail as well.
If you like this video, be sure to check out some of the other videos on my channel. Click here for my trap tutorial, and here for my factions base tour.
Make sure you like and comment to this video. One random commenter will be built a fully automatically resetting trap by me, RonnygoBOOM. Check the description for more information.